Joanne and her husband Ray get into a fight about their relationship while driving home after spending Thanksgiving with Joanne's parents. Their small daughter Perry loses her compact mirror after coming from the bathroom, so the parents go in search of it. A dog on a deserted construction site startles Perry while Ray is preoccupied. Ray starts Les Perry with a rock to frighten it, and as a result, she tumbles into the pit. Ray stumbles into the hole and strikes his head while trying to grab her, and he watches as a scared-looking Joanne descends, worried about Perry. Once his mind clears, he travels to a hospital so that Perry's wounded arm can be evaluated. Ray and Joanne refuse a request for Perry to be registered as an organ donor during the drawn-out admissions process. A physician examines Perry, finding a fracture. In the event of a brain injury, Dr. Bertram suggests a CAT scan. Ray nods off at the waiting room and Joanne follows her to the scanning facility in the lower basement. When Ray asks the hospital personnel if he can visit his wife and daughter after waking up many hours later with his forehead sutured, they inform him that no such record exists. Ray came by himself and was treated for a head wound, which upset him, according to the lone nurse from the previous shift who was present. Security puts him under sedation and locks him in a room after pepper spraying and restraining him. In order to counter the sedative and get out to the parking lot, he swallows multiple adrenaline auto-injectors that are stored in a cabinet. Two policemen accept his wave and promise to look into it. Ray, the two officers, and a doctor point them toward the imaging lab on the third floor rather than the basement. As the nurse recounts what actually transpired with him, Ray grows furious. Dr. Bertram says Ray confused him when he said he intended to wait for his first wife, who has since passed away. Reminding Dr. Bertram of the chat Perry had with him, he declares that Abby is dead. After watching video from a surveillance system that was delayed, the security guard notices that Joanne and Perry are missing. Enraged, Ray recognizes the gas station cashier as a witness, and the officers decide to find her. It's Ray who discovers Perry's bloody scarf. Dr. Jacobs queries Ray about alcoholism and the vehicle accident for which his file states he had treatment. Ray responds that he has been sober for 8 years, but he disputes the idea that his alcoholism was the cause of this illusion. Noticing to Bertram that Joanne and Perry could be at the construction site, Dr. Jacobs advises that Ray go with her and the police. However, Ray accuses the staff and police of hiding Joanne and Perry's absence. A big puddle of blood and Perry's broken compact mirror are discovered by AK 9 Unit. Ray keeps making accusations even when the police officers show their incredulity. When Dr. Jones asks him to describe what happened before the accident, he makes up recollections of it, which prompts the police to accuse Ray of murder. Seizing the chance to divert attention, Ray puts Dr. Jacobs under duress and demands her hospital keycard. Ray drives to the hospital after disarming and confining the officers in the restroom, recalling the vehicle accident that claimed the life of a pregnant Abby. Disguised as a doctor, he enters the elevator and chokes a security guard. Ray discovers disemboweled bodies and nurses hauling human organs in the basement. He discovers Joanne unconscious and Perry surrounded by surgeons getting ready to remove her organs. Despite the surgeons' objections, Ray gets them out of the hospital, gets them into the car, and drives them home. Ray sees things differently than they actually are. He takes an unconscious patient instead of saving Joanne and Perry. Actually, Ray injured his head badly trying to save Perry from a catastrophic fall into the pit after startling her. Joanne was then flung to the ground and her head was impaled on a section of rebar by him. Ray then separated his perception from reality, placed their bodies in the trunk, and headed in the direction of mourning.